with dynamic bending lights, also the LED daytime running lights. You know, in our research, these especially resonated very well with consumers. They noticed those like right away and actually referred to them as diamonds and sparkling. And I think you'll notice on the road today, it really gives a very unique front light signature to the all-new Elantra. Also, hands-free smart trunk, which is tied to our proximity key. LED taillights, also to provide that unique light signature. The available 17-inch alloy wheels that are standard on the limited trim, and also door handle approach lights tied to the proximity key. Once again, another kind of like customer delight feature that you don't really expect. You might not experience when you're looking at the car during the day in the showroom, but when you get home and you go to that car for the first time tonight, it's kind of a neat way to approach your car and show that little door pocket illuminated. Now, safety. Safety is a big item for Elantra. It's actually, and we talked about the democratization of technology, these are technologies you would not have seen in this segment just a few years ago. These were usually reserved for premium level cars, even optional on those premium cars. And so we like to have that technology migrate down to midsize and now to compact segment to offer these technologies at a lower segment. So I'll start off with automatic emergency braking with pedestrian detection. We have a radar sensor in the front grille and also a camera mounted on the windshield. These two units work together in what we call sensor fusion to basically continually determine what's ahead of you, what are you closing in on, somebody moving in front of you, to basically warn you. And then if there's no action at that time, it will apply some braking effort. And then depending on that closing distance, it can even apply full emergency brake effort. And as we mentioned here, it also can predict pedestrians, which is unique to the segment. Now, having that front sensor also allows us to have smart cruise control. So basically, there's one of four distances that you can set. You can set your speed, and then if somebody pulls in front of you in the lane, it'll automatically slow down. Once they exit that lane, it'll automatically speed up. So you can basically almost have a not touch the brake, not touch the gas from Orange County to San Diego. It will disengage about 6 miles an hour, but at that point, you're going so slow, it's just an initial final brake application. Moving on to lane departure warning and lane keep assist system. Now, lane departure warning is starting to show up in the segment, but we take it a little bit further. We don't just warn you, and there are different settings in the menu that you can have standard or warning only and active. So I encourage you to try those out today. But if it does detect you exiting the lane, it will not only just warn you, but if it's set to that setting, it will apply a little bit of steering torque to bring you back within the lane just to kind of keep you in the intended direction. Also, rear view camera, which is becoming more and more prevalent and will be, you know, regulatory here soon, but we like to add even a little bit more value with the rear view camera that people have come to expect by adding dynamic guidance, which actually, you know, does add some value, backing in and out, parallel parking. It's just a nice feature. Once again, usually reserved for premium vehicles, now happy to say on Elantra. And blind spot detection. Now, in our research or third-party research, when you look at demand for features, and we do give them a price because you just can't say, I want this, I want that, they have to have some sort of calculation in their mind what it's worth. And the price we give them is a very, you know, fairly fair price value. It is probably the highest ranked safety feature of all the safety features we look at, regardless, like I said, of our research or third-party research. And then if you take a step back and look at the full global set of features, including multimedia, other things, it still always ranks very highly. So because of this high-level demand for this feature, we will be offering blind spot detection on a very high percentage of the Elantras. And it's not just blind spot detection, it's also lane change assist, which will evaluate the lanes behind you. Now, if there's a car closing at a high rate of speed, when you go to signal to change lanes, it'll warn you even of that. And also rear cross traffic alert, which actually occurs on a high percent of the basis. It works under 6 miles an hour when the car's in reverse and you're backing out of a spot. And many times, especially like at Starbucks, when people are flying in and out trying to get their coffee in the morning, that will actually activate a lot. And it's a very helpful feature, so sometimes it is a little bit difficult to see behind. So all this leads up to what we anticipate, based on our testing, is a top safety pick plus rating, with a good in the small overlap, which is the 25% offset at 40 miles an hour, and also a superior front crash prevention rating based on the application of automatic emergency braking. Now, moving to the inside. As devices become more and more prevalent, I think you'll be wrapped up two people in a car, both have phones, Elantra Limited has dual charging USB. We have the traditional USB up front, which is for power and for data, but also in the center console and the armrest console box, there is a second charging port, USB port, that you can charge devices. Also, integrated memory system. This works with the power seat and also the drivers are the exterior mirrors. So you can set one or two settings, have multiple drivers. You can memorize not only the power seat, but also the exterior mirror settings. And the mirror settings is segment first. Also, leather seating, dual automatic temperature control with auto defogger, auto-dimming rearview mirror with home link and compass, and then heated front, and what I always like to refer to as kind of a Elantra hallmark, heated rear seats as well, which is very unique to this segment. Now moving to infotainment, and Scott mentioned that the dash panel layout, you know, really puts a prominent spot for these audio systems. And also, you know, you'll notice on the inside that center stack is actually at about 7 degree tilt towards the driver, which makes it even more intuitive and a little bit easy to use. In our research, people love the layout of the controls. Everything was easy to find. Everything was easy to use. Traditional knobs to change volume and tuning, so it's very well appreciated. So we have three levels of audio. We have the base audio, which is in the base car configuration, and then as you'll see in my packaging here shortly, you just move one little step up to the popular equipment package, and that's where we just apply display audio, which is a 7-inch touchscreen. So it's a very advanced system at this kind of price point. And then also above that, on the cars you'll be driving today, is our navigation, embedded navigation solution, which is an 8-inch touchscreen. Happy to report that both display audio system and the 8-inch navigation system both offer support for Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. So I've sat in very many focus groups, and consumers always will say, I just want this experience on my phone on the screen. And it's not that easy to do. There's a lot of issues you got to address, driver distracted being a big one. Working, you know, with Google and Apple to bring true smartphone integration to Elantra. Once again, that display audio, as you will see, is in the popular equipment package, so very properly priced. Also, the center instrument cluster displays have been upgraded, not only in size, but resolution, and that allows us to provide more information for the driver. Even on some of these, well, the cars you'll be driving, you know, a lot of them with the 3.5-inch or 4.2-inch, it'll actually give you individual tire pressures based on TPS. Once again, nice thing that you wouldn't expect necessarily in this segment, not just the idiot light that comes on to tell you. It tells you what tire and by how much. Also, our next generation BlueLink, which I'll show some statistics here afterwards, which has support for smartphone and also for wearable devices. And you kind of saw that feature in that Super Bowl spot. You might see that as well on some of the Elantra spots where we talk about the integration with a wearable device. Also, display audio and navigation have HD radio, Sirius XM Travel Link, and TuneStart. TuneStart is, you'll notice when you go to the Sirius XM channel, your first six presets will be recording. You can go back to live and skip back. So it kind of brings DVR function to satellite radio. And then finally, our 8-speaker Infinity Premium Audio System, which we worked very diligently with Harman to bring out, but it also has eight speakers, including a subwoofer and a center channel, but it also has Clari-Fi, SE trim, and then the Eco trim we've been talking about later on this year, and then the Limited trim, which is our more premium luxury features on the Limited. So the SE is available in three configurations. You see the standard equipment there. Obviously, the 2-liter new, all new powertrain is new. Drive mode select is new. Driver's knee airbag is new for Elantra. Projector headlights is standard. Seat height adjustment, actually for the passenger seat as well. And temporary spare tire is standard for Elantra. So you make a very manageable, about an $800 walk up to this popular equipment package. And that's where you get the all-important display audio with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Auto headlight control, 16-inch alloy wheels, some other nice benefits, Bluetooth, etc. I expect this to be a really strong performing option package, and you'll see when you see the pricing, especially with that, how I mean about that. Moving on from the package is the tech package. So this is our highest equipped SE. Some of the more technical features come in at this level. LED DRLs, this is where blind spot detection gets applied, and everything above this will have BSD. The upgraded center display cluster, leather steering wheel and shift knob, automatic temperature control, proximity key, some other features. So this is basically our highest level equipped of SE. And then moving on to the Eco, basically the content of the Eco is identical to that SE tech. Typically when a buyer is more eco-focused, they still want a level of equipment. Little variations, obviously the engine and transmission is different. We changed the 2-liter for the 1.4 turbo, and the 7-speed DCT is standard, and a 15-inch alloy as opposed to a 16-inch alloy for the focus on fuel economy. Moving to the Limited. Limited is available in three configurations. The base Limited is a very well-equipped car. The 17-inch alloy wheels, side mirror turn signal indicators, the LED taillights, chrome exterior accents, leather seating surfaces, power driver's seat, and rear armrest. And also this is where our BlueLink Connected Care system comes in, and also the dual USB charger. Moving one package up is the tech package. This is where the navigation with the 8-inch screen is applied, the Infinity Premium Audio, power sunroof, heated rear seats, and auto-dimming mirror are part of this tech package. And then finally, the ultimate package based on the tech. This is where HID headlights are with the dynamic bending light, automatic emergency braking, lane keep assist, smart cruise control, high beam assist, and the integrated memory system are all part of this ultimate package. And everything you are driving today is equipped as such as the ultimate package, so all the features are there. Elantra is available in 8 colors, 5 of them are new. For the SE and the Eco, we apply gray or beige cloth depending on what exterior color the vehicle is. And then on the Limited, we have gray, beige, and black leather available, once again, tied to certain exterior colors. And to the pricing, I'm happy to report it starts, 2017 Elantra starts $100 less than the outgoing 2016 model. So the SEMT starts at $17,150, $18,150 for the automatic, and there's that $18,950 pop package. So basically before freight, under $19,000 for what I feel is a very well-equipped and a very competitive vehicle. Moving on to SE Tech, Limited starts at $23,350 and going up to Ultimate, $26,750. All prices, $835 freight is additional. So here's a comparison I kind of do with the Civic, all-new Civic 2016 LX. The CVT starts at $19,940, so our SE Pop is almost $500 lower than the entry or starting Civic. But for that difference, you get our 7-inch display audio versus their 5-inch screen. You also get Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Alloy wheels as opposed to steel wheels. 60-40 split folding rear seat, which I think is a very big deal. 6 speakers as opposed to 4. We have additional tweeters. So when you look at some of the content differences, I think the SE Pop package is very well positioned against the Civic and kind of supports that value positioning that Elantra has been known for in this segment and looks to maintain. And then basically just some comparisons of the standard equipment, some of the items that we have that some of the competitive set might not, whether it be like satellite radio, remote keyless entry, the 6 speakers I spoke to, driver's blind spot mirror, which actually works really well. If you don't have blind spot detection, the mirror is actually a pretty good solution to that. And then once again, the POP package, features like drag mode select, our alloy wheels, not everybody still, but some have steel wheels at this position, and that display audio, and Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, which I think is so important for Elantra. And then finally, the limited starting part, or the base limited, LED taillights, side mirror turn indicators, blind spot detection, not available on a lot of the competitive set and vehicles in this class. So kind of some key takeaways. Premium design, that class above, interior size that Scott spoke to, the overall is a very well-designed package. The driver confidence, and I really think you're gonna experience this today, and I can't wait to hear about it. The ride quality, the NVH, it really drives like a class up car, in my opinion. I think we've got some great roads for you to evaluate this on, and the new powertrains. Advanced safety technology projected to achieve TSP plus rating. Safety is obviously very important in this segment. And all the safety technologies that we've applied to the vehicle as well. And then finally, thoughtful features, whether it be the dual USB charging, integrated memory system, the Clari-Fi music restoration technology, just looking out for our owners and taking care of them.